guys, how you doing? Here we want to show you today how to install door casings. All right, first thing you want to do is make sure the door's prepped. You can see we did prep it already. Next is you're going to measure one side. So I like to go left, top, and right. So press the tape measure, make sure it's firmly on the ground. Do is basically I go exactly the height of this inside right here. It's showing it's 80 5/8, and since we want 1/8 reveal, meaning it's gonna go in 1/8, the casing is gonna be 1/8 in from this jam, I'm gonna add 1/8 to the 80 5/8, so that's gonna give me 80 3/4. All right. Same thing over here. Now we measure the top. This one needs 36 3/16. And once again, we're having a reveal of 1/8 on each side. So we're adding 1/4 inch to that measurement, which will give us 36 7/16. Same as the other side. So once again, medium 3/4. Now go outside and cut these. All right, we're ready to cut here. So this is the left side here. And usually you want to inspect the edges. Here it's pretty straight, it's pretty nice. So I don't need to cut this end. So now we'll just take our measurement, and as you know, door corners are 90 degrees, and half of that is 45. So, first measurement is 80 3/4. Mark it just exact. Now, line it up with the blade. If you're new to this, I would recommend cut a little past the line. See, there's my line right there, and it's on the left side of the blade, and this is the side we need. So here I'm gonna cut a little long at first. And then your second cut, closer, or get right to the line. There you go. Left side. Right now we're cutting the middle, and I forgot to mention earlier, I'd like to mention now. Casings, you want the thicker part on the outside, because that's the part that butts up right against the baseboard. Alright? And the thinner part in the middle. So when we cut these, you want to make sure that the angle you're cutting it in is going towards the middle, pointing to the middle, to the thinner part. Alright, this is one side here. The angle to the left. Measurement. So it was 36 3/16, the exact measurement, and we're adding 1/4 inch, so that's 36 7/16. And what I do is I just firmly press on the other side. For those of you that are new, I know it's hard to measure when it's inside and going inside. So what I do is I get the measurement over here, the exact measurement. On this side, I just press this firmly into the molding. You see the indention? Then I mark. Cut. It's the same thing. If you want, cut a little long. So you can cut your way into the line if you're a pro like me. Next, before you install the casings, what you want to do is mark the 1/8 reveal. So I start at the top. And I'm going to go from this edge, 1/8 in. Are bold. And since we have about a 5/8 thick jam right here, we can get right on the crease and kind of angle it slightly towards the jam so it's, you can pass it as securely. So I want to push this outside a little bit. Going to nail everything, make sure all your lines are lining up. Right, over here, even though your corners are completely lined up and butt against each other, you see the header molding will still kind of bend down. That's because this molding is bowed going in. Typically moldings will bow towards where it's thinner, where there's less mass. So what you want to do is obviously nail this corner first. That's how you install door casings. You can use the same method for windows too. They're the same things. Anyways, I hope that's helped you guys, and come back for more. Thank you.